Yes.
I don't think I've ever worked this hard in my life.
Never? I don't know, Tom.
Okay.
Okay, y'all can come out now.
I think we're live. Cat live. What are you doing hiding behind us? Go check and make sure that everybody's happy with us and that our sound volumes are beautiful. We're not blowing out the eardrums.
Man, the Twitter woman.
Yes.
Woo.
We've got a show to do.
All right, Holy. We do. Sorry we're late.
Sorry about that.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, I feel much better.
Let's see, Tom 1, Technology 0.
Right.
We win.
Hi everyone, I'm Tom Perdue, otherwise known as Dworgyn or One-Eyed Jack, and I have a co-host with me.
That'd be me. I am Professor Falmea, CD producer, MMOs.
Awesome. That's right, you're Falmea in both games.
I am.
I forget sometimes. Yes. Very cool. Well, welcome to KI Live. I am glad that we're able to have this tonight.
Absolutely.
Obviously going to go a little long here.
Yeah.
Getting started a little late.
We hope you won't mind.
We're here.
We've made it.
I'm stunned, actually.
I thought
we're
going
to have to cancel, but we're here. Okay, now, we also have our man Decius, which you saw behind us.
Yes.
He's controlling above. We're going to have both Pirate and Wizard.
Yes.
Display. Oh, looking to move the screen around.
Ooh.
So if you're in Pirate 101, go try to find, I think that's One-Eyed Jack, realm. Yep. Go find that and get in the camera, and then we'll be switching between that and... Oh, look at them all.
Oh, yeah.
Right there
in
the shopping district. I believe Falmea. I think
Falmea. One-Eyed Jack.
There's a bunch of people hanging out there already, though.
Yeah. They'll find it.
So.
They'll find us.
Today, we will be.
Day.
It's a very special day. Yes. I've been sick.
Yes.
I'm better now. I do have a plugged up ear right here. Oh. It's kind of throwing me off. Oh. It's really gross. I'm sorry. Don't use these headphones. I wouldn't recommend it.
I won't. I'll leave those all to you.
But we delayed a week because I was sick, and now we're on. We almost had to delay another week because of technical difficulties, but here we go. Now,
we're here.
People, yes.
Where are we in a wizard?
I think Falmea. I don't know. We usually do Falmea.
Okay, that just looks different.
Well, we are in the shopping district, not the main commons area, so it's a little different. Shopping district.
Makes sense.
So, we've had people asking us over the past couple of weeks now questions to the Ask KI hashtag on Twitter. We've gathered 10 that we think are excellent, and we're going to be answering them. And those people that asked us those questions, if we use their question on KI Live today.
What do they get, Tom?
I've made a special bundle. Now, last time I made Tom's crazy bundle.
Yes.
Remember
this
that?
One, yes.
Car sales
it was crazy.
Tom. This time we have Tom's, and for Valentine's Day, Red Hot Bundle.
Ooh.
You know what I'm talking about? Red Hot. You can't have Valentine's Day without Red Hots.
Of course not.
So
I'm a big fan of cinnamon and Red Hot.
Right. Well, I love cinnamon and those little tiny Red Hots. Mm-hmm. They're great.
Yeah.
So those
the
and
Red
lemon
Hot
heads
Bundle.
Just remind me of the movies as a kid. So we will be having the, if you get that bundle, it's got the Fire Schoolhouse. It's got an extra castle elixir. It's got a Hotzilla. Because it's the hot bundle.
Oh, yeah. Spicy.
You've got a Solar Saber mount.
Ooh.
Permanent. It's my favorite.
That's a good
mount.
One. That's a good
and
one.
And I also threw in there four Rattlebones Exalted Duels, one-shot gauntlets, so you can get some clothes, whatever you want from those.
Rattlebones is red hot and spicy.
Well, yeah. Sure. Can we make a variant of Rattlebones? Let's make a note of this. He's all red, and it's the red hot Rattlebones. And Joel has written it that out. Okay.
We'll make that.
And, of course,
5,000
crowns to do with what you want to do in the bundle. Thank you. And I hope you enjoy my invented bundle, the Red Hot Bundle.
Yeah, I like these creative bundles. I think they're good. Thank you.
Until we get, like, an actual bundle in stores that's new, you know, might as well be creative.
Yeah.
You know?
It'll happen.
Right.
Yes.
Okay, so let's talk some wizard news.
Wizard news.
Let's see, we had so much go on since the last time we met.
A lot of stuff, yeah, especially because we're even a week later, even a week more of
things. A week more of stuff, it just doesn't stop.
No, it doesn't stop around here.
We had Packapalooza, we had Double Gardening Rewards, we had Lost Pages event, we had Throwback Thursday, and of course the Friendship Festival, which just wrapped up. And that was awesome. We had a brand new Friendship Oni pet in the Spiral. Very cute little guy.
Both in Wizard and Pirate. But
yes, in both games.
Both games.
Right. And then the traditional ones like the Soaring Heart Wings, Lovely Ladybug, and the Leopard, and all that.
All those cute, cuddly, and fluffy cute, cuddly, Valentine's Day
fun
stuff.
Things. Yes, who doesn't love pink wings?
Who doesn't?
I don't know. I don't want to know that person either. I'm just kidding. We also had a level 50 elixir cell. That's something
we sure
never
did.
Done before.
New.
It was like a flash one day, 33% off. So it brought it down from 30,000 crowns to 20,000 crowns.
That's fantastic
it
deal.
It is the most yeah. expensive item in our crown shop, right?
Well,
so
yes.
If you were holding out.
If you wanted it, you got it.
Right. I mean, that's a good deal.
Sure is.
And who knows? Maybe we'll see more of those in the future. We don't
Perhaps.
Know. Maybe.
Perhaps.
And we had a small update to Wizard101. Crash bugs.
A few little, you know.
Crash bugs.
Bugs getting here and there.
Reshuffle
and
needed a little work. We fixed that.
A little bit
that
of love. That one took a lot of time and energy to pin down, but we think we've
The way
it.
We want it.
We
maybe.
Think we have it the way we want it now.
Reserved
Hopefully.
For the future, possibly. Who knows? And currently, we have double pet experience running for members.
Ooh.
Everyone's favorite.
It's a great time to be a member.
It's not gardening, and if it's not pet experience, they're asking for it. Because those are their two favorites, right?
They're good ones.
They are great
they're
ones.
They're good ones.
So, excuse me while I advertise for 7-Eleven.
Can we get sued for that?
No. I don't think so.
Let's hope not.
So, double pet experience going on now through Sunday, February 26th.
Sunday. Yes.
And speaking of, we had Packapalooza, but guess what? Boom.
We
had another flash sell.
Whoa.
Unheard of. Crazy. Packs. 50% off.
Whoa.
On the Gulcher's Horde, Road Warrior's Horde, and Immortals Lore Pack.
Fantastic.
Also through Sunday. Yeah.
Those are some good ones, too.
Yeah, it's a really good sell.
Absolutely.
So, and then, of course, next month is upon us already, you know.
So soon.
February is such a short month.
Yeah, it's almost over.
You'll see more crown stuff, crown shop item stuff, and Pat of Gold. Our favorite. Pat of Gold. Put on your green. Don your green and get your rainbow staffs. Pat of Gold be in the house.
Yes.
So there you go.
Oh, and next month we have a special surprise guest.
Guys, tune in next month because we've got something we've never done, a special guest.
Very unique. First time for everything. Yes, we're excited.
I'm excited.
Yeah, it's going to be cool. But
And it's someone that people know, but we're not saying.
Don't give out hints.
Oh, sorry. No hints.
Too many hints.
Kat says no hints, so.
Okay, great.
Well,
is our guest coming soon?
Soon, yes.
All right. Joel's on the case.
All right.
They're ready for you. Come on in.
Well, we do have a guest, but I suppose we could move on and
maybe talk about
pirate stuff first.
Right.
Yeah.
So, Pirate. Packapalooza was also running in Pirate last month. And guess what? We removed those soggy socks.
We did.
We left a little Olaf in the...
Well,
one little Olaf. It's a new game we're playing. Find the hidden snowman on Skull Island. It's a little tricky to find.
Well, he told us he wanted some warmer weather, so we decided to let him.
He's under a palm tree. You know, he's hanging out.
In the shade.
He's doing good. He's nice.
Yeah, he's comfy.
Find the Olaf.
He's comfy.
I wish we'd give a badge. I wish Olaf would stay forever, but I think he's going to go too eventually.
Well, we'll see.
Oh, well.
I don't know.
Friendship Pony, like you said, was also in Pirate 101.
Absolutely.
And we had a cool pink jaguar mount.
That's pretty cool.
And that wasn't in Wizard.
Yeah.
And I had a wizard say, hey,
it's
I want
pretty.
That pink jaguar. Where is that?
It's pretty.
Right? I want
so
the Mary
pretty.
Kay speed ride.
The Mary Kay jaguar.
It's pink.
Fantastic.
Okay. And now this is another flash sale.
26th.
26th through the 26th.
Yes.
All companions. Well, you're not going to get the Christmas ones, you know. Holiday ones.
All available companions. Currently available companions.
40% off.
That's a lot of percents.
It's a lot of percents.
A lot of percents.
It'll save you a lot of cents if you want to buy more companions. And we had a test run party.
Yeah.
So we needed to test. That went great.
Good.
Oh my gosh. I actually have a few pictures to share.
Cool.
From our test run party, if you don't mind. Let me see if I can get these up. So we needed to stress test some new hardware, and we decided as long as we're doing it, let's have some fun with it.
Yeah,
let's have
course.
A party. And so we announced it. Our fan science announced it.
Test round party.
And we had tons of people show up, and I dropped turrets. Turret. It was like, I was mean. I was out to get people, you know, that kind
you
of thing.
You do have a little mean streak in you sometimes.
It was a little scary. I had like turrets on either side of the wind lane. I'd go down and I'd be like, okay, I'm going to drop like 10 around Rapa Nui. And then, oh no, Rapa Nui's under attack. Go get him. And then I'd drop him around the Jonah town. Turrets everywhere.
Turrets everywhere.
I'd never seen before. It was really, really cool.
That's cool.
I dragged them between the underneath the bridge. Now you can sail between the bridge. Oh, so awesome. And then we did pet sparring. Okay, I got a few pictures that people sent me. Ready? From the test round party. Here we all are at the end saying Boochbeard. Instead of cheese. I was sending out these system notifications like this one. Several turrets can be found between Skull Island and Blood Shoals. Help! And there they are, all the people flying their ships. There's Chrissy. She was hanging out pet sparring. Apparently, Chrissy did not win any matches, but had fun anyways. And
look how cool these are.
Yeah, they had a lot of fun hanging out in the test realm. This was a good match. Anyways, you get the idea.
Very cool.
I just want to give a shout out to our pirate testers.
Yeah, that was really
short notice.
Awesome. Thanks, guys.
Showing up. And they did a great job.
Speaking of Yar.
And our special guest.
Yar
is here.
Special guest. Come on.
Everyone, welcome. The man, the myth. You haven't seen him since November 2015
here,
when he was on the show previously.
I'll back up and.
Are you going to be in the middle?
Yeah, I'll be in the middle.
This is unheard of. I'm usually. What? Mike Sears, otherwise known as Thundersnake? Mr. Gandry?
I have a question.
Thundersnake.
Are you choosing a new name? Are you going with those names? It always seemed kind of up in the air. Is that actually what we're calling you?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't remember signing up for those things.
Get over here. Thundersnake.
I just jump on to answer questions when someone's being mean. And then I answer the question and I forget to go back on. So I don't even know what my...
Get over here. I'm not going to bite. Maybe.
Let it be known, I just introduced Mike as...
Thundersnake?
Thundersnake?
No.
Mr. Gandry?
Mr. Gandry?
No. One of our MMO writers, voice actors, and talented friend.
Aww.
Yes. You know what? Mike does a lot. You started out as a designer, right?
I started off as an intern.
An intern? Are you kidding me?
And they didn't know.
We never do interns.
Not anymore. Probably because I screwed that up for everyone.
You became legit.
Yeah, I just kind of floated around for a couple of days until they were like, you can do this less bad than some of those other things you were attempting. And I worked my way up.
Nice. Well, that's cool.
Yeah.
So last time you were on, this was actually November 2015. It's been a long time. You talked about, you know, how you'd done side quests in Polaris.
Mm-hmm.
You talked about, you know, other things that you'd written, especially Pirate 101 quests and everything like that. What have you been doing since then?
Since then, we have been in a... I'll go small to bigger. I still have a passion for pirate, and... I will never not be a pirate designer, so I like to jump in there and do as much as they'll let me do in the world building side. And as a writer, I get to be in the same room as the head writer, so I get to subtly influence things as much as I possibly can.
Nice.
And you get to be there for the brainstorms, which is fun. And then when I'm not doing that pirate stuff, I'm doing all the brainstorming and story content to help with our head writer for Mirage, and then all the side quests still. So
nice.
That took a long time.
Okay. What was your favorite thing you wrote for Mirage?
The Sinbad side quests.
Sinbad side quest.
Mm-hmm. I'm looking and all I see is your hat. There you go. Now you're better.
Perfect.
Much better.
Thank you for adjusting us. Our professional adjust.
We have a quick question. Someone asks, actually, Dylan Roach 011 asks, was Mike one of the voice actors that did a walrus voice in Polaris?
Listen to you coming up with your great questions. How perfectly droll.
Why don't you give him a nice little run?
Yeah, give us a run through of some voices you've done.
Yeah.
Let's hear it.
See if people can guess which characters they are.
Yeah, let's do it.
Both from Wizard and Pirate.
All right. On the spot.
On the spot.
We're putting you on the spot.
Well, see if you can spot both characters to use that voice. You get extra points if you spell the first one correctly. Those Chrysalis folk had some funky spellings.
You got a correct answer over there, Kat?
Keep going. You can use
okay, next one. Next one.
Oh, man. On the spot. I don't know.
Yeah,
Kat, you'd know better than I would.
We didn't warn you about this.
I said he's done more than enough characters, even like, how about, let's do some Mirage stuff.
Mirage?
Yeah, you got anybody from Mirage?
Yeah.
I feel like I didn't get to do that much.
You didn't do any voiceovers from Mirage?
I did. I didn't get to, I've had more of a role in the writing process, so I had more like actual work to do, and I couldn't
That's some
jump
pirate
in.
Stuff.
Yeah. Let's hear your Gandry again.
Nobody wants to hear that.
I love Gandry.
No, not.
How about we do the rest of the interview in Gandry?
All right.
Is Gandry, what about Milo Greytail? I hate him slightly less than I do the Gandry voice.
Someone guessed that you did one of the seals in Polaris.
Seals.
One of the Navy seals.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. Someone's bright.
The troll.
The troll?
I feel like you've done a
troll. Actually, the Polaris side quest troll I wanted to do, but we had an actor come in who did it so much better that I relented. Yeah, it's the same actor who does Fitzhume, whose name I'm blanking on. Just thought I'd throw a little shout out to voice actors out there.
Nice.
Someone says Family Guy voices.
Family Guy voices.
Someone else also says...
I don't do Fitzhume, which is...
Oh, Private Snow for
players. Yeah, that was his name.
Yep. good job. Thank you.
You did it.
All right, so we actually have some player questions.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Player questions. This one comes from Ibrahim Wiz, 786. He said, ask KI, was the Thieves' Den in Mirage a reference to Star Wars?
Yes, it was.
Fun fact, actually, when we had the cantina music in for a little while behind the scenes, and first I was like, oh my gosh, this sounds just like the cantina music. And then I went and talked to, I think it was Kat. I was like, Kat, is this actually staying in? She's like, no.
A little too close. A little too on the nose.
This is
right?
Actually the cantina music. I was like, okay.
That's pretty funny.
Yeah, that one, as someone of my generation who does what I do, it's very hard to not reference Star Wars all the time.
Yeah.
And with this one, it was kind of like, let's just do it. Let's go. The whole nine yards.
Right.
Let's just rip it right off.
That's awesome.
But
I enjoyed them.
We at least referenced more of ourselves in the Thieves' Den than we did anything.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, much better now.
I have a large head.
A large head. You're leaning a little forward there.
I know.
I can't do voices like you. All right. Next question. This one comes from Wanderer of Worlds at Rebel Firefly. Yes, Baba has the egg, Cyrus has the harpy and Quetzal. What pet companions would the other teachers have?
I mean, I have to jump in and say Falmea would have the fire cat. Does have a fire cat. So. Mm-hmm.
Pretty no-brainer.
So that's a no-brainer. But what about the rest?
What do you think?
Whew.
What do you think, Ryder?
Let's see. We'll give old Halston something fly related, probably.
Fly related?
Yeah.
Oh, because he's
as a frog.
That's a frog with a fly pet. Yeah. The glowbug.
There we go.
Glowbug. Yeah. That's a good one.
Man, that's an in-depth question. That would.
It is. Yeah.
There's just so many pets.
I actually have something that a player drew to show you.
Okay.
And it was on. It was Chicken Love on Wizard101 Central. Drew this wonderful picture. I'm going to show it to you now. Of Dworgyn with a pet wormling.
Aww.
See, I would have given Dworgyn the bunnies, the two little cute bunnies.
No. This is much. This fits Dworgyn much better. Look at that little cute wormling pet right there. Right.
He had those
like the
undead
one.
Unicorn.
Yeah.
Zombie corns.
Yeah.
Dworgyn seems like he might run around with one of those.
Wasn't that pet your idea?
Yeah, the death unicorns.
Yeah.
My daughter did a concept art drawing that was horrible. Luckily, it didn't actually be the real concept drawing. Anyways, death unicorns.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Grey Rose would have to have the ice beetle, of course, because, you know, on the website, the fire cat and the ice beetle kind of wrestle. Mm-hmm. Right.
Yeah, I think our pets would play together mm-hmm. nicely.
Well, there you go. Good question.
Yeah, there's just so many pets.
There's so many pets.
So many pets.
So many. I like your
Hundreds.
Idea of like a glow bug for Halston.
Yeah.
Someone says
Cthulhu
and Jerol are other voices you might have done.
Cthulhu Jerol. Oh. Oh yeah, lots of feet on that cat. Centipede.
All right.
Too funny, man.
Meowing Wolfie, at Wolf Iceblood, asks KI, is there any Valentine's Day spell that you'd create, and what class would it be, and what creature would it be?
Ooh, a Valentine's Day spell.
Create a spell for Valentine's Day.
There's a lot of ways I could go with this.
Okay.
And I'm gonna go with a myth spell, but I don't want that. I don't want anybody to like read too far into that.
Love is a myth.
Yeah, it's more about the creativity and the companionship that conjurers inherently have with their magic.
Mm-hmm.
And it would probably be a love bug.
Aww, that's cute.
And the love bug.
That you smash! And it flies away and never comes back.
It's okay. It's okay.
Myth.
Myth. It's okay.
A myth spell. The love bug.
Myth spell.
But it's got to be deadly at the same time, right?
The mythic love bug.
The deadly mythic love bug.
Right. But never.
It should cast a beguile on you or something, you as well as damage you or something.
Absolutely.
All right, cool question. Next! And final question for you. These guys back here talking. Adger917, I don't even know how to say your name, dude. Sorry. He asks, the outside of the Arcanum reminds me of the storm gates of Pirate 101. Mm. Is that where the Arcanum is? Traveling between worlds?
Hmm.
That's a interesting question.
Yes, it is.
Really? You're just gonna go straight yes, huh?
And it's a dimensional library consortium of information, man. Folding space and time on itself, finding one point to one point. There is no in between.
All right, that's where
the Arcanum is. Make sure you pay your late fees, kids.
And he's out. You can't follow that. That was good.
Let me type this down. That was really confusing. Outside of the Arcanum, maybe a Western music.
It's a long question. It's a convoluted question, but it's a perfect writer question.
Can you paraphrase his questions, Mr. Writer?
Okay.
So they're gonna work it out, and we'll figure it out.
Right,
but
this is gonna be good.
Thank you to Mr. Mike Sears.
Thank you.
Thanks for
goodbye.
Dropping by.
We'll see you again in 5 years. Oh, they're taking pictures and selfies back there. Aw,
selfies back there.
What is this? What is this nonsense?
Okay. Where were we?
Well, we talked about pirate news.
We did. And
usually at this point we talk about mobile game news.
We do.
But I am so sorry. I have no news to share about mobile games.
Hopefully some cool stuff coming up.
Next month I will have news to share about mobile games. So there you go.
Almost certainly.
And with that, let's jump into gameplay.
Let's do it. Yeah. So this month we decided to go with lesser known love stories.
This is your idea.
I mean, we wanted to go through each game and kind of pick a side quest or something that was maybe not part of the main focus of the story, and we wanted to highlight two love stories. So,
two love stories for
Wizard first?
Wizard first. Let's do Wizard.
Wizard is, we're doing a quest.
Excuse me.
So, a dangerous little thing called love.
Right. Now, they're lesser known quests because they're side quests, mm-hmm. right? Okay. Let me go over here to Wizard 101. Here we are. For sure. Brandon Alsord.
You're what?
You wrote this one?
I wrote that one. I'm also the voice of the boyfriend.
Oh, cool.
I'm pretty sure.
All right. Well, heads up for some Mike Sears.
Mike Sears' voice. Here. He is the voice of the boyfriend in this particular quest from.
And wrote it.
Sarah. Now, it is a good thing that I typically don't do side quests because I have the side quests available
to
my main character.
All right.
What realm are we on in case people want to join us? Scarecrow, Area 1.
Scarecrow 1.
All right, guys. Let's talk here to Sarah and start our lesser-known love quest.
Lesser-known love stories.
Me, Sarah, Eridwin, need help. You, Spellbinder, give help, yes? Good.
Let me turn up the volume on the app. Or is that my ear? Is that my ear that's bad, or is that my... Let's turn the dial off.
They're a champion of many things, except love.
Aww.
Sarah try show love to Jorah Stonart, but Jorah run away like coward.
Sad.
Tried to show love.
Jorah infuriates Sarah. Jorah head too thick to understand we in love. Sarah not know what else to do. Sarah very sad.
Oh, this is a sad love story.
Spellbinder must tell Jorah that Jorah's soul belongs to Sarah for all eternity. Use force if have to, just not too much.
I like Sarah's attitude on this one. I gotta get the quest going.
All right.
Oh my gosh. Do I have to show people? I have so many side quests I haven't finished. Oh. Volume's too loud now? Of the game. Okay. Okay. All right, let's go talk to Jorah Stoneheart.
Let's do it.
Right across the tent here.
What do you want? Sarah sent you?
No,
hurt me. Please, I do nothing to deserve this. Why does Sarah haunt me?
Okay, that's got to be tuned up a little bit, man. That voice. Yeah, pitched up.
Sarah not love me? Sarah want to steal my soul. Sarah say so right before Sarah hit me in face with rock.
That does not sound like love to me.
I am confused.
I am also
if
confused.
If Sarah Eridwin love me, why she almost break my nose?
Okay, let's find out. What's going on, Sarah? Hey, everybody. How you doing?
Hello.
It's Valentine's Day.
Does soul of Jorah Stoneheart belong to Sarah Eridwin for all eternity now? No. Sarah enraged! Why, Spellbinder, fail? Jorah confused because Sarah almost break Jorah's nose?
It's sinking in now. You don't slug someone if you...
So Sarah just need break Jorah's nose completely.
No,
then spirits bind together as one forever and ever. Yes?
Oh.
No? Oh! Love! love is such agonizing battle.
Sarah's
heart crumbles.
Poor misunderstood Sarah.
But Sarah never give up fight. Just need new attack plan. Right. Jora not comprehend obvious love gesture of rock to face.
Rock to face.
Slow. Must find new way to make Jora understand.
Okay.
Sarah know. Spellbinder distract Jora, then Sarah attack. Still too much? Hmm. Maybe just give Jora gift?
The dancing
yes.
Bears.
Oh, my. Oh, all these.
Jora run from Sarah.
I'm in love with the bear.
So Spellbinder give Jora kiss or death.
Apparently.
No, not real kiss. Death stalker venom.
Oh, man, this is getting worse.
Spellbinder, fill this vial with kiss o' death venom from Deathstalkers, then give vial to Jora.
No, Sarah,
Jora
no.
Love venom!
Jora love venom. All right, we gotta defeat Deathstalkers. Collect the kiss of death. Let's go, guys. Let's go, team. Team kiss of death.
Team kiss of death.
Here we go. And here we are. We've got some Deathstalkers. They're waiting for me.
All right.
I'm going in. We got us a full battle circle.
Full circle of death. Stalker.
Dolan Boomgarden. Dolan Boomgarden. Say that 10 times fast.
Dolan Boomgarden.
Dolan Boomgarden is about to hit and do some damage to the Death Doctor.
Did we break you?
I got a cough drop in my mouth. Well. He's blading up, so I might as well join in on the blading up.
The blade party.
All right, Dolan, make us proud.
Go to Dancing Bear to entertain us.
I love the Dancing Bear.
A Dancing Bear and a goblin.
Oh, we got a critical.
Oh, yeah.
He almost got him with no blades at all.
Done.
Nice one, Adam Darkblood.
Good time to critical on KI Live. I mean, come on. Well timed. Good job.
All right. Now, come on, Dolan. Will he fizzle? That's the question. Will Dolan fizzle? Has this portion of Chrysalis ever been this fun? Right now. Look at all these
people. I think
people.
This is probably the most fun of this portion of Chrysalis right here. Never seen this many people dancing in one sigil.
Everybody get dancing. Everybody in this sigil just dance right in the middle.
I want to see dancing.
Let's see this. Oh, that is a...
This looks like the bear's casting spell.
Nice. Oh, they got a little life back.
Oh, wait, no.
More transformations. It's a cornfield dance.
More dancing.
Oh, my pet's got to show off.
I want dancing.
Everybody's dancing, but my pet's got to show off.
Yeah, good job,
guys. Oh, here we go. Now we've got the wolf right in the middle.
Yeah.
I'm being surrounded by love here.
Oh, my God.
For Valentine's Day, they're showing me the love.
So much love.
Okay, Dolan's throwing his Tempest.
All right.
Come on, Dolan, let's see it.
Let's make it happen.
And here comes the hit.
Yeah.
Oh, these guys are so dead. 40, 40, 30,
whoa.
40. Oh, overkill. Oh, 8,000. No more Deathstalkers. The question is, did I get the poison I needed on that one time? And the answer is?
The answer is... Victory!
2 of 3. All right. We need one more, guys. I'm just going to jump over here. We got this one warming up for us. Okay, here we go. Bailey Seacaster. And everybody is hanging out here, and we are ready. We got a Tempest throwing right off the bat.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I'm just gonna pass and enjoy the ride.
Just let
Nicholas Winterhorn. Nicholas says, oh, where am I? Drommel outfit. Boom. Oh, we're done. Let's see.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, we got some that added in late.
Dope.
Dope. Every good love story has venom in it, right? Right?
Yes.
Every love story is filled with venom. Deathstalker venom. Bailey's throwing. I think I'll I'm at the end, so really my blades here aren't gonna help anybody, but maybe I'll Nicholas.
Yeah, maybe next round. Well,
but I don't
we'll
think
see.
These guys are gonna last in the round. So.
We got it.
And critical! Oh,
oh.
Critical blocked. There we go. That critical is not blocked. And here we go. The frog. A little throw up time. So I had a debate about what those are in the throw up with Leela way back. Is it wizard hats or butterfly wings? Why not both?
Why not both?
Wizard hats. I mean, because, you know, he could have swallowed wizards. That is a little gruesome.
We'll have to ask Russell.
My pet's once again showing off.
Cinematic artist. Woo! Cool pet.
Yeah, I got an old school spud pet.
Nice.
Casting unicorn for everybody.
Nice.
Done!
Got it!
Goal Woo-hoo! Complete. Collected kiss of death. Alright, here we go. We will avoid this one. Over here. Talk to Jared. All right.
Let's see if this was successful.
Let's see what happens now.
Yeah.
Jorah, guess what I have for you?
Not you again? Is that venom? Sarah sent you to poison me? Ah! What? Kiss of death is gift? I not understand. Why Sarah give me a beautiful vial of venom? Is it my birthday? Is it token of love?
Love is so confusing.
Oh! I understand now! Sarah loves me! Why Sarah not just say so? I honored Sarah love me.
Aw, that's cute.
What I do now? Sarah fiercest of all warriors and prettiest. I too nervous to talk to Sarah alone. Spellbinder, come too?
Sure. Sure. Let's go talk to her. Let's see what's what.
Jorah! Greetings! Sarah see Jorah's nose healing funny. Sarah mean swelled nose make Jorah look ferocious.
Way to recover, Sarah. Way to recover on
there you
that
go.
One.
You're learning.
Yes. I should be able to smell again soon. I come to thank Sarah for kiss of death venom. I love venom. And I love Sarah.
Finally. Sarah very happy. Sarah, oh, much thanks.
No,
Spellbinder,
no, okay.
Stand still while
okay,
Sarah pummels Spellbinder with
no.
gratitude.
No, we gotta get out of here. She's gonna punch me.
Wait. No more pummeling.
Oh, thank
Jorah
you. Thank you,
and
Jorah.
Sarah just use words to thank Spellbinder for bringing us together.
Jorah's trying to teach here. It's a teaching moment.
It is. Thanks, Jorah.
Thanks, Jorah.
All right.
And thank you, Kingsisle, for the 525 gold.
Yay.
Look at these great guys. Look at all these people.
Yeah.
Scarecrow, I believe. But we're about to leave.
Yeah, we're about to go hop over to Pirates and check out the other lesser.
Thank you, everyone. You are amazing. Wait, happy Valentine's Day.
All right. We're getting like mob. So
that's,
much love.
That's a beautiful love mob right there. Wow. Thank you, guys.
All bear and unicorn and dragon and that, manner of
that
thing.
That horse. That yes, horse, though.
That horse.
Huh.
All right.
Huh.
All right. Let's move
Let's
on.
Go over to pirate.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yar.
So, yar.
Yar.
Now, let's go back to pull up here for a second. For pirate, mm-hmm. we decided what for a while we wanted to choose Cowardly, Amber, Devereaux, and her ninja pig are being spotlighted right now.
Look at that.
We got a big crowd over there in pirate. Look at those pirates!
Oh my gosh! Woo!
Look at those
Look at
pirates.
Them.
There was a conga line earlier.
Oh, guys. Aww. Nice showing. In pirate. Look at those guys. Look, they're drinking out of the fountain over there, all the
they
horses.
They are. There's all those horses and a duck.
And a duck.
Love the duck.
Golden Christina on the duck.
Golden Christina. Way to be different.
Way to own that duck.
Way to own the duck.
Okay, so for pirate, there is a low-level quest.
There is.
And originally we thought, well, we should do El Toro, because the El Toro story
I mean,
is the
hello.
Love story of Pirate 101, right?
But then we went lesser-known love stories.
Lesser-known love stories. Plus, I don't have anybody read at El Toro at the moment. So, this is a good thing,
conveniently
right?
enough.
And I have a low-level character
mm-hmm.
That I happen to have right there ready to go. So, let's go back into Pirate. Here you are, Pirate. And, Noble Carrick Dove.
Quite noble.
Quite noble. We're going to turn on and we're going to turn down the music a little bit. Actually, the music isn't too annoying here in Pirate. And then we'll turn up the dialogue.
All right.
We're going to do Love's Locket Lost.
Love's Locket Lost.
You can join us in Blood Shoals for this quest if you'd like. Now, let's see what realm we're in so people can come to us. We are in Gandry 1.
Gandry 1.
Area 1 on Blood Shoals.
In where?
Pirate 101.
Gandry Realm.
Gandry Realm, yep. Area 1. And we're located in Blood Shoals.
Blood Shoals.
As the location in
Look,
in
Black.
The
Orion Percy is hanging out with us. All right, Danny Ratso. Let's talk to Danny Ratso, see what's going on here.
Danny Ratso.
There's no deeper wound than lost love. Oh. I loved a girl, pirate, a girl sweet as summer. She'd have married me if I hadn't been such a fool.
Oh, Danny, you've been a fool.
My sweet Nancy gave me her mother's locket as a keepsake. And what did I do? I lost it in a game of dice. Gambling's always been the ruin of me.
He lost the locket. Gambling.
Surly John Remington took the locket from me.
Don't do that.
And Nancy left me forever. I meant to get that locket back to her. But now it's too late.
When you log in, you just get your account.
Oh. I thought I was on a different account. No, I was on a different account.
Really?
You know what? I bet you my wife at home was trying to log in.
Okay.
I'm gonna bet it was my wife at home.
I'm just logging myself.
Okay. Well, there you go.
Oh.
Thank you, pirate. Find Surly John over on Skull Island and get the locket back. Take it to Nancy and tell her I'm sorry.
Okay, Danny. You know what? We'll tell Nancy that you're sorry. So let's go talk to Surly John. And we're gonna leave our little mark here. In case we need to come back to talk to you. Okay. Let's find the quest.
Love's Locket Lost.
Love's Locket Lost. Sure. I'll be your buddy. Where's my quest arrow, y'all?
Go back. Quest helper.
Quest helper on. Ah,
there
that's
you
better.
Go.
Oh, let's take my beautiful raft back to the mainland. Actually, you know what? I can just go to Skull Island.
That would be a quick way to do it.
I love quick ways.
Mm-hmm. Efficiency.
Thank you, Kingsisle, for your quick ways. Okay, here we go. Surly John Remington in Remington Steel.
Surly.
Let's see what happened to this locket. Here we go. Remington Steel.
Danny the Wolf Rat? Sure, I remember him.
Oh, he
sent you for the locket, did he? Ha! He lost it to me fair and square.
Oh, he's mean.
Won't he?
Of course he's mean.
Sorry,
I don't have
it
anymore.
Go catch me some Batacuda for my dinner and I'll tell you where it is.
Oh, rude. He wants Batacuda in exchange for information. He wants us to get him dinner. I have to get someone dinner?
Just to help somebody else.
You know what? A good dinner is part of a Valentine's Day tradition.
That's true.
Wouldn't you say?
A nice piece of fish.
Right. Do we have some... We've been avoiding a bunch of questions, I think, that we need to answer.
Oh, goodness.
We need to have a
Thank
bunch
you.
Of questions.
Let's yeah.
Go, let's go through a bunch of these.
Let's see. Well,
I thought we were being too silent.
Yeah, I'm like, oh, we don't have much left. Sydney Elaine.
Okay.
What is the most commonly purchased elixir? Least common.
Ah.
Well, Sydney Elaine, the most common by far is the energy elixir.
Energy elixir!
That one's probably
it's really
kind
not
of
a
obvious.
Surprise.
The least common is the gold boost elixir.
Huh.
Elixir.
The elixir.
Gold boost elixir. Say that one 10 times.
Gold boost elixir.
There you go.
Let's defeat some Batacuda. Anybody with me? Anybody?
I think you're on your own.
I think I gotta defeat some Batacuda here.
I think you're alone now. Oh, Pebble Beach Wizard.
Okay.
Asks,
so, yes, Red Hot Bundle for that question
yes,
on which
bundle.
Is the, obviously, Energy Elixir and Least Common Gold. Okay.
What is the amount of most caught fish in chess for a single character? Inspired by a friend.
Oh, right. A friend. We got you, Pebble Beach Wizard.
Yes.
We got
you. We got you. And the answer is Moira Darkhunter has caught over 40,000 fish.
40,000
fish!
You know what? That's actually an update, right? Because we found this out back in June 2016, and it was still Moira Darkhunter as our leader.
That's right. We did have
a and... she still holds the lead. That's like 20,000 more than they had before. So
a whole lot of fish.
Moira, nice job on all the fishing.
I'm going to guess that she's probably bought an energy elixir at least once.
I think probably an energy elixir was purchased.
Maybe not, but just...
Oh, we're back in Wizard!
Woohoo!
Oh, did you see that nuke? Get him, Bonnie Ann. I am joined by Noble Nicholas Norrington, Triple N Threat.
Yeah, very, very good alliteration there.
He's making short work of this for me.
This is good.
Watch this.
Expediency.
All right.
All right, more questions?
Yeah, let's keep going with the questions.
Yeah, Elijah Darkdust.
Elijah Darkdust.
What are the top numbers of evil magma peas planted per wizard or count?
Okay, we had to qualify this one a little bit. Let me make sure. Steven Spiritwalker is the person. Swiftwalker. Sorry, Steven Swiftwalker has planted, guess how many? 40,004.
40,004!
Probably more than 40,004 by the time that we are doing this. Evil Magripes as of Valentine's Day. So, the next closest person to Steven Swiftwalker is Anna Dragon Whisper with over 32,635 evil magma bees planted.
Get your chest. Get your chest.
Oh, yes. Let's get some. Get some money.
That's a lot of evil magma bees.
That's some double gardening reward.
Oh, yeah.
Fest. I collected 5 fresh barracuda.
Yay!
All right, we got to go back to Surly John Remington.
Surly John Remington.
We're going to port back to Skull Island once again. Okay, good question. Good question. We'll get you a red hot bundle.
Yeah.
Red hot bundle.
Rawr.
What's the next question? Let's just keep going.
The next question. Oh, I didn't know if we were going to talk to somebody soon. Hunter Gray.
Okay.
Asks if there was a way to play the old Wizard 101 of 2008, would you play it, and if so, why?
Ah, like a Wizard 101 classic server.
Yeah. I don't know. I really think that Wizard has gotten better with age. I like the Wizard that we have now. I think if we could have had the Wizard that we have now back then, we probably would have.
Yeah.
I don't know. We kind of started as a theme park with a couple rides, and we've just been improving the old rides and adding new rides with, you know, more stuff to do or extra systems like, you know, pets and derby and PvP and all that stuff. And so,
it would be kind of fun.
It would be kind of novel
to go back, and especially if, like, in the crown shop or the old crown shop items that you can't get anymore.
But you'd be missing a lot of crown shop items. You wouldn't have all the cool things. So, I understand the nostalgia, but my answer is no. I like it. I like Wizard as it is now.
Actually, I think it's a much better game as it's aged. But it would be kind of fun to do a classic server. See what it was like when Mushu was the top world.
That's true.
Those were good times.
It was good times.
And the friendly necromancer was some kind of blogger.
Who's
guy.
That guy?
He wasn't working for Kingsisle.
Who's that guy?
But that's the thing. You can't ever recreate the old days because it was the crowd, it was the time, it was the place. And if you go back to a classic server now, it's like it's lost a little bit of its charm.
You have these.
You're trying to get back to that charm, but you can't really get there. And now you know, like,
yeah, even if you were to play the old Wizard back then, it would be like, oh, this is so cool for a little bit. And then you're like, wait, where's my quest arrow? Because, I mean, we didn't have quest arrows.
Right.
Where's my pets?
You'd open up
where's
the map
mounts?
And look for the icon on the map. Yeah.
So,
good times.
I understand the nostalgia.
It was kind of fun.
I think it was fun. I mean, it was cool. But
that's a good question.
Yes, good question.
And I
good,
like it because fond memories remind me of Valentine's Day.
Fond memories. Oh.
I got a friend fest going on here, by the way. All right, let's do Love's Locket Lost.
All right.
Keep going here.
All right.
Oh, good. I'll eat well tonight, pirate.
He will eat well
tonight.
Oh,
well, great. I hope you enjoy that Batacuda steak. I gotcha.
All right. Come on.
I pawned it a while back.
Madam
Bianca.
Bianca
the jeweler. She likely still has it.
This is going to be a wild goose chase.
You know, love is not easy. Love is a long quest.
Love
you do what you gotta do. Do you like my Tom's Nuggets of Wisdom?
Love is a many splendid
love.
Thing.
Love is a long quest. Quote. Hey, Kat, I think that's
it.
Tom says
she's on it.
His advice. Love is like a long quest.
No, that's not what you said.
Oh, what did I say?
You said.
Would you get the quote right, Tom? It's your own
long
quote.
Quest.
I think I know what I said. Okay.
Sally John's locket? Yes, I still have it. I'm afraid the locket is not for sale.
She will
relax.
Trade it.
I won't sell it, but I will trade it for a favor.
Oh, a favor?
In the cave behind the waterfall, near the entrance to the ancient tunnels, you'll find an old broken chest, half buried in the ground. I hid something under that chest a long time ago. One of my rivals is very eager to take it from me. I dare not lead him to it. Go dig up the pouch under that chest, bring it to me, and make sure you aren't followed. Do this favor for me, and I shall give you the locket.
Huh. Okay. All right, next question while we run over here to the waterfall.
Next question is Blake.
Okay.
He asks, what is your favorite spell for Valentine's Day?
What is my favorite spell for Valentine's Day?
It's gotta be Beguile. Gotta be Beguile.
Beguile with the hearts spouting off from someone.
Yeah. What do you think?
It's truly a loving spell.
Have another spell or are you going with Beguile too?
Well, I love blades, and I love my balance wizard buddies.
Yeah.
So all of those balance wizard blades show me the love. And thank you for the love. I feel like I'm waxing very poetic about love here in Wizard 101 right now. All right, let's see what's in this chest.
Oh, yeah. Pouch. What do we got?
Oh. Let's get it back to Bianca and claim our prize.
All right. Let's claim our prize.
Let's claim our prize.
Oh.
What just happened?
I tried to click off something because someone friended me and
oh,
I
no.
shut down the game.
Oh, no.
Here, ask me another question while I log back in.
Okay. Well, this one's probably more for me, but...
Oh, this is your question.
Yeah. Joe... can you read the Quirly Roho one. Okay. What is the process of putting a new world together? And Flint Dragonheart is his in-game name, apparently.
Flint Dragonheart.
All told, it takes about a year from start to finish. First we decide what we want to do, you know, come up with the concept, like, vegetables in Roman times or pigs in space and no that's
vegetables in Roman times pigs in space
it's the these are
you're
not,
giving an example
no,
right
these are examples this is an example
the next
of things
world?
That we're not gonna okay. do no that's not a hint I promise
what about bacon on the breakfast table I like that better than
ooh.
Pigs in space
ooh bacon on the breakfast ooh bacon
the bacon world.
Okay I lost my train of thought now so we kind of put together a plan of what we want to do. And we have a concept artist that will draw up, sketches of what we want it to look like.
Yeah.
And then we have other artists that will actually build those things in 3D, like the world you're seeing and the characters and all that. After that, we get a designer that kind of stitches everything together, so they'll take that world and make a place for you to walk and make sure you can't walk off that bridge right there, but you can walk on it. And they'll place the characters in game and place the monsters and decide how the monsters are going to react and all that.
Mm-hmm.
And then programming writes code basically to do anything we haven't ever done before. If we want a spell to do something new, or we want a character to do something new, or we want cameras to do something cool, we'll take that to a programmer and say, hey, can you do this? And they'll always say, yes, we can.
Sure
sometimes
they
it
do.
Will take longer than we have. They'll always say yes. It can be
all right.
Then sound adds the final layer of immersiveness with music and VO and environment sounds and character sounds and footsteps and all those fun things. And then we get QA to test everything. So QA's job, you know, a lot of people are like, oh, you're QA, you get to play the game all day, that's cool. Well, instead, QA has to run into the same wall like 10 times. To make sure
running
you don't
into
fall
the wall hard. 10 times does not sound super
it's,
fun.
It's not as
that sounds like work.
It is work. And, they have to test the quest with 4 people. They have to test the quest with 1 person. They have to disconnect in the middle of the quest. They have to do everything they can to mess it up. Then once we're pretty sure that it's not going to mess up, we go to the test server and then we go live. So that is kind of a very simple simplification of our process.
Flint, you asked the senior producer what it takes to build a new world.
And That's the short answer. I mean,
did you even hear a word? It was just kind of like, we got programmers, we got designers, we got artists, we got sound.
Thanks, Tom.
We got QA. You know, and here I am at the top of the chain, overseeing.
I gave a quick rundown of
Well,
we make up stuff and put it in game. Okay, thanks.
Concepts to art to animus to design, sound, video, and lots of testing.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Good job. Nice summary, Cat.
Yes.
Cat Live is.
Yeah.
On
why didn't I think of that? That could have been so succinct.
Well, great. Let's see what Love's Locket Lost brings
us now. All right.
Us now.
And those are all of our questions.
Good. Is that it?
You
yeah, I think
it.
So.
Excellent. Here is the locket in exchange.
I think you got 10.
A pleasure.
We asked
doing
quite a few to
you.
Mr. Sears
come back
before.
Anytime.
That's why it feels like.
Oh, this. We got the locket.
Oh yeah.
We got the locket.
All right.
She's a beauty. Let's take it to Nancy. I know where to find her.
All right. Bonnie Ann knows where Nancy is. They're besties, apparently. Bonnie and Nancy. Besties.
Besties. BFFs.
Someone make some fan art. Bonnie and Nancy besties. Oh, well, of course. Nancy's just right up here.
What do you want,
Nancy.
Private? I've no time for... Danny? Danny sent you. Nothing to say to him or to you.
Oh, no. Come on.
Of course.
The locket? He got it back, did he?
Yeah.
Well, it seems he could keep his word after all. Took him long enough.
Well. you know, it went through a lot. She doesn't even know the half of it, though.
Yeah.
I'll never buy Danny's pirate and gambling ways, but at least I can forgive him. You could tell him that for me.
Oh, well, okay, we got a glimmer of hope.
It's something.
You know, sometimes people are pirating and gambling. You can't forgive them, but...
You can
can definitely tell him for a little bit of XP. This is a friend fest over here.
Thank you, pirate. Here am I, standing in blood shows, branded a fool. I could never win her back. But Nancy knows my love is true.
Ah, you're welcome, Danny Ratso.
Ah, well.
And 65 gold. And Danny Ratso.
At least has some closure.
Closure. That's what we've given him. The gift of closure. And... lesser-known loves.
Lesser-known love stories. That wraps up lesser-known love stories.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for joining us.
Yeah.
For our lesser-known love stories, Valentine's Day-themed quests.
Oh, yeah.
That was a good time.
Hey, Tom.
Yeah.
You want to maybe show him a new pet that's going to...
Oh, wait.
Should we do that?
Yeah, let's... So we've been doing this the past couple times. Okay. We've drawn a pet out to show you of a new pet that's coming to Wizard 101. We showed the kookaburra.
Mm-hmm.
We showed
I'm picking the next one out of the cheese hat.
You're choosing it?
I'm cheesing it.
Oh, you're cheesing it. Oh, the bad pun was dropped. All right, let's go ahead. Okay. Which pet are we doing?
We are doing...
Death! My school! My school, we shall see, and I know what this is, and it's going to be very... Hang on a second. Ooh, let me select this.
Yeah, let's find it. What do we got?
Okay.
This one's cool.
The Gulcher.
Oh, yeah. All right.
I kind of saw that one flapping at me as I was playing through Mirage and thinking, that could make a great pet.
And well, we've got it as a mount in the Gulcher's Horde pack.
You
but
get a mount, you get a
you
pet.
You don't have a culture pet unless you're a death school.
Huh.
Death school wizard.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, I think we've seen three pets now.
I believe so. Three? Three or four?
Three. Well,
Three.
That's
I think
an interesting
three.
Observation.
I forget. Yeah. No, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, three.
All right, so we also have some player screenshots, right?
Yeah, this was where you and your friends love to hang out.
Okay, yeah, so today on Twitter we asked you to share with us pictures of where you and your buddies like to hang out, or just you and your buddies hanging out, you know, share some screenshots. And this is what we got from you. This one came from Alex Lotus, obviously from the Santa run.
Right. That's a pretty
look
cool...
Look at all those Santas.
Yeah, that's a pretty cool Santa picture.
This one comes from Alex Wizard Pro.
And you like to hang
this
out?
This is best friend and tournament partner, both.
Yeah.
Autumn.
Aw.
It's nice to have a buddy to PvP with you.
A battle buddy.
Alora Skullhammer sends us his picture and looks pretty amazing right there. And a buddy, Angel Hexcaster in the background.
Yeah.
Hanging out.
Having
doing
fun.
Our thing. Aww. Amber, that's pretty cute.
Got to hang out with their gobbler friends.
Gobbler buddies. Andrea Rose, apparently they were missing a friend. Robert Legend.
Legend Desk?
Desk? Something like that.
Okay, cool.
Nice.
That's a pretty good Photoshop.
Really good. Excellent Photoshop skills. Andy Full, 1998, hanging out with his... Mirage Buddy.
Yeah.
House guest, right?
Mirage Buddy.
Angela Shadow Garden.
Hanging out in the party tent.
Party tent. It's a gloomy background with a party tent.
It
and
is.
You're going to have a Halloween party. I think that was part of the... And I believe this is Paige Moonshade back here.
Kind
of
spooky.
Yeah, doing some Halloween partying.
Yeah.
Anna, Scarlet Rose Wiz. Still buddies with these people from 2015.
Aww.
And hopefully for many more years to come.
Yes, absolutely.
And thank you for being friends on Wizard 101. Ashley Firebreeze.
Oh, they're bunny buddies.
Yep, bunny buddies.
Bunny buddies.
Say that 10 times fast.
Bunny buddies. Bunny buddies. Bunny buddies. Bunny buddies.
Bailey Terra. Just got some really good buddies. The crew, the fam.
All the saber-tooths.
Yep. Blaze Shadow. Doing some some battling.
Zachary Mythcaster.
Right. Fighting some Fangs Assaulters. Blaze Shadow? Wow. That's quite a list of buffs going on.
Yes.
Right there. Now that's when you know you're loved, when you got all those charms and by your buddies, right?
They get by with a little help.
Oh, we already saw
friends.
This one. I got it twice by accident, sorry. Vanessa Mythdust.
All right. The egg.
The egg. The hard boiled egg buddy. Along with Robert Stone and Jesse Shadow casting up some spells. Chris Nightdreamer. Hanging out, chilling with his mummy buddies.
Mummy buddies.
And Grace, of course. They look very spooky together.
They do.
That's a good couple shot right there for Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
Chrissy the Blesser, hanging out in Pirate, right? Got some Pirate buddies. Those are some great looking staffs there.
They look very, very good together.
And Chrissy the Blesser sent us this one also from Avalon.
Avalon.
Look at this looks very color coordinated here. Nice. That's a great shot.
They're like their own Knights of the Round Table there.
I actually really like that screenshot a lot.
It's a good one.
Destiny Rain. This is the adult Facebook group that's out there. And that's all of them hanging out at a party.
Party.
Dougie.
Got Paige Moonshade and Kelsey Fireheart and
Iridian
Willowcloud.
Yeah, that's a good crew.
And Sir Riley. Oh,
Sir Riley and Samson Midnight.
Yeah.
Those are buddies. Edward Lifegem. Oh, he's getting ready. This is from last year's St. Patrick's Day event. And there's probably going to be another St. Patrick's Day event. So
cool.
Make sure you check out Around the Spiral blog so you can join in. This is also from Edward, and this is in Pirate 101.
Woo-hoo.
Got a whole line of pirates there hanging out, having a house party. Emily Williams, this is a garden party that they threw.
Aw,
mm-hmm.
Look at that. They look so fancy.
They're fancied up for a garden party. There you go. You need a Alice in Wonderland themed pack. How about that?
That would be a cool idea.
Wizard101 M's, hanging out in the hatchery. You're going to find friends in the hatchery. That's where people are. And I'm going to murder this name. Eddie, 6566. Eddie.
There we go.
Hanging out with Vanessa Mythdust. I believe that's Vanessa. Or if not, it's someone that looks an awful lot like Vanessa. Best Buds. Flash 33 from Celestia Days has an old friend, and he sent this picture over. Remember the good times in Celestia.
Aww.
Also from Flash in Pirate, this is the humans of death. Not the ducks of death, but the humans of death. Fred is just, I guess there's nothing
he
that says love more than
battle.
Nuking something down for 62,000 points.
Yes, that's a whole lot of love right there.
Frostcaller has a Pirate 101 picture here. All those buds, and look, they're color coordinated and matching.
They're matchy-matchy. Yep,
matchy-matchy. And Abraham? Hanging out with Valdis. And Jenna Connington. I believe this was from
Bunny Run?
A Bunny Run.
Yeah. I mean, there's lots of bunnies, so
lots
it would
bunnies.
Make sense.
Yep, Silver Dragon Love. Doing a 4v4 tourney.
Woohoo.
And Silver Dragon Love hanging out with her daughter. This is actually from the test realm party that we had for Pirate. It's good to have kids as friends, right?
Yeah.
Kate
look
Keegan.
At that rainbow.
That is a nice rainbow of colors. Yep. Hanging out with the crew, close buddies.
Rock stars.
Karen Hodges, Wizard Rule.
It's a pretty cool
Say no
picture.
More.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's nice.
Wizards do rule.
Oh, no. Dad Siren, that does not show love. Take care.
Take care. No.
I guess teasing your friends would be part of the fun, right? Yes. Valencian Pirate. Hanging out with Elizabeth Shadowhorn and Matthew Dragonblade. and Matthew the only one hanging out. That's some decorations right there.
Absolutely.
Night Wyvern. They're having Minotaur dancing.
See? They sure
Minotaur
are.
Versus Minotaur there?
Yep.
Paige Skyhaven. That's a fun party.
That's a lot of friends there.
I think Paige said that this was from a Twitter event from last year.
Look at that.
That's a good party.
It's a whole lot of people.
Patrick Fairy Stalker, the Sloth Friends.
Sloth Friends.
Did you know the very first one that we did, you and I, these KI Lives together, mm-hmm. you became the new mm-hmm. host? We had a sloth parade.
We did have a sloth parade. That was super fun.
So we're sloth buddies with these people.
Sloth buddies.
Pebble Beach Wizard again. Aww. You know what? Photoshopped. No friends, but Aww. Five friends all to himself.
Well, you know, fake it till you make
Sometimes
it, right?
Sometimes you got to be your own friend.
Sometimes you have to love yourself.
Maybe if you leveled up, you'd find more friends, right? Sephers. Here we go. Sephers showing off.
All right.
Got some buddies.
All right.
Shauna Icebeer.
Aw, graduates.
Now, these guys have been besties for almost 10 years. How about that?
Wow.
Silver Blossom. Hanging out in the hatchery.
Yeah.
Nathan Ashley.
You will find a friend there, for sure.
And Bruno. Simon Wizard in Pirate. He said Gortez isn't the only golden monkey, right? Good buddies. Simon Wizard, critical friendship with Valcor. That's Valcor.
Critical friendship. Right. That's cute. That's adorable.
That's a cute term. Zachary Sackett, Blaze Dragonbud, and him hanging out on their choppers. Chopper buddies. Stormy 12, having some PvP with his buddy. Sydney Elaine, hanging out, doing their pirate thing.
Doing the pirate thing.
And there they are with Zadok.
Yeah. Looking cool in their sunglasses.
We have great friends. This guy in the middle.
Yeah,
they do look pretty cool in their glasses, don't they? Tara Windwalker. This was at a women's march in game. And has all of her buddies listed down here. Valor Wolf. Hanging out in Valencia.
See
these mustaches?
Cool. Yeah.
We need those in Wizard. That's what I'm saying. And getting closer to the end, I believe. Kirsten. Got a couple Kirstens.
All right.
This is from Fire 4.
Dance party.
With the best, and that's with his best friend, M.
Yeah.
And Ninja Steppy. No parties here. Blah. Hanging out in the comments. Of course. And there you go. That was amazing.
Look at all that love and friendship.
Thank you for joining us for our Valentine's KI Live. And we have a code for you.
Yes. Thank you for bearing with us in our technical difficulties and a little bit late start.
So sorry, we got a late start.
Hopefully it was worth it.
Yes.
Hopefully it was worth it.
Whew. Need to get home.
I know.
Hang out with the fam.
Yeah.
It's almost 6:00.
Show them some love.
So our code, thank you for waiting to the end, is redeem the code TABLE42. That'd be TABLE, TABLE, the number four, the number two. TABLE42, get it? Get it? TABLE42?
I didn't actually just get it until you.
TABLE42? Yeah. You looked at it, we're like, TABLE42.
Like, huh? What?
Is TABLE42 where you're taking your wife? No. TABLE42.
TABLE42.
And if you redeem that code, you get a free 2 Hambrosias. That's the best mega pet snack.
Best, yeah.
In Wizard 101, and 2 El Doritos in Pirate. Also
yum.
The best mega snack.
Super yum.
TABLE42.
TABLE42.
And there's 2,000 of those for the first 2,000 that redeem those. And when we upload this to YouTube, we'll probably add an extra 2,000. So thank you very much. It was a good time here on KI Live. I'm glad we successfully did this thing. I was sweating bullets there for a while.
Pushed that button that last time and just hooray, it worked.
Hopefully next time it will go much smoother. And we can't wait to see you next time.
Yes, next time.
Couple special guests.
Special guest.
And catch you next time.
See you later.